Positively Arts. We empower kids for life. We are a 501c3 nonprofit, and our mission is to empower, inspire, educate, and heal youth from all backgrounds through the performing arts by developing social and emotional learning skills and fortifying mental resilience by providing the tools, coping mechanisms, and positive outlets for self-expression. We empower in schools through our anti-bullying programs. We empower with confidence, teaching students that their voices matter. Through our Positively Leaders program, we empower fearless leaders by creating a training program that teaches students about leadership, financial responsibility, resume building, and creating internships that reinforce life skills. We empower with mentorship by encouraging our student leaders to then teach the next generation. We empower our communities through outreach in schools and community centers. Through our recitation program, we empower with mindfulness, giving students the tools necessary to cope with stress and anxiety, creating time to stop, breathe, and reset. We empower with empathy through camps and classes that encourage compassion, acceptance, and self-awareness. We empower through the arts, and our Get Launched Vegas program connects students directly with the professionals from the entertainment industry in a safe and supportive performance environment, emphasizing that even an obstacle is just another stepping stone to our goals and successes. Positively Arts, we empower kids for life.
Hello, everyone. How's everybody feeling out there? Welcome. My name is Pilita Simpson, and I am the founder and CEO of Positively Arts. I don't know if you know. Thank you. I take all the woos. I don't know if many of you know how we began, but 8 years ago, we started as a way to give back to the community and provide free arts classes, programs, and trainings for families in need. So if a child was suffering, we work with cancer survivors. We work with students who are bullied. We have partnerships with Cure for the Kids Foundation, Nevada Blind Children's Foundation, Nevada Childhood Cancer Foundation. And we started as a nonprofit that served those kids who were at risk. And what happened over the next few years is we realized that every single student is at risk. And what I mean by that is every student is in need of empowerment, of uplifting. In a time in their lives when they are bombarded of who they need to be, what they need to do, what they need to be when they grow up, we found that we needed to create a safe and supportive environment where kids can just be. And the artistic expression that they are allowed gives them so much confidence and courage that we opened up Positively Arts to all students of all backgrounds. So the reason we have a fundraising component to Get Launch Vegas is because we are still that nonprofit. We still provide families who cannot afford it free arts opportunities to do what they are passionate about, regardless of their ability to pay. So thank you so much to everyone who's created a fundraising page for us. Thank you to everyone who's donated to our 50-50 raffle. This goes directly to families. So without further ado, welcome to Get Launched. This is our mentorship component competition, but all about kids getting confidence. And we couldn't do this without our wonderful mentors and judges. So I want to introduce these three lovely people in the casting booth. Give it up for our judges up there.
Hey, everyone. My name is Deidre Lang. I was a judge last year, if you guys recognize me. I've been in Vegas for a little while. We came out here with The Lion King when it played at the Mandalay Bay. So we've been here a while. I've been performing most of my life. And I'm just excited to be a judge. You know, I'm excited to see everybody. Everybody is so talented. You know, just go out there and have fun. It's nothing crazy. You just have a good time, you know? And we're here to support you and give you some critiques. So, yay!
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Douglas Crawford. I've been blessed to perform professionally in the entertainment business for about 35 years now. I've been on stages around the world, on Broadway, here in Las Vegas, LA, some film, television. I'm nothing if not passionate about the arts and about Positively Arts, which I was introduced to last year through this program, Get Launched. I was a proud mentor of two contestants, one of whom won the whole thing that you're going to meet here pretty soon. But I just want to say to everybody, after all of my experience, I still battle all the time with nerves. So to the contestants performing momentarily, take a deep breath, take away that competition aspect, and just go out and do what you love to do and you're passionate about. And that's all we ask. We're here to support you, not really judge you. If we can come up with constructive criticism, we'll try and do that. But you are all superstars, and we're excited to listen to you this afternoon.
Hi, everyone. I'm Allie Madrigal. I was very fortunate to have won last year's competition. Doug was my mentor. We won it together, and I'm very blessed to be here and excited to hear everyone. Good luck, have fun, don't be nervous. This is your stage. Have a great time. Thank you.
Thank you, judges. On that note, it is pretty terrifying to be up here, so it is up to you to create positive energy and applause to keep these kiddos going. So do me a favor. Everyone look at your kiddos. Let's give them a wave. And on the count of three, we need to give them a reminder. We need to say, just have fun. On the count of three, here we go. One, two, three. Just have fun. That's right, you guys have worked so hard. Everything you did up until this moment, all we wanna do is hear your passions and what is on your heart, and you are gonna do great. On that note, are you guys ready for your first performer? Make some noise. Please welcome to the stage, Miss Allie Mishler.
Hi, 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 it's Allie on the mic. It's Allie on the mic. What? It's Allie on the mic. Can I get a beat? It's Allie on the mic. It's Allie on the mic. Maybe you're not plugged in, or maybe it's a mute button issue. Hey, you're looking good though.
Thank you. There I am.
Okay. Ready, and take two. Welcome, Allie Mishler, everybody. So, Allie, how old are you?
I am 16 years old.
Sweet 16.
Yes.
So tell us, what song are you doing today, and why did you pick that song?
Okay, so I'm doing In My Dreams from Anastasia, and I got this song from one of my friends who actually just left for college. She performed it last year in a show we did together, and I heard her sing it over and over and over again, like backstage, but it never got old, so I just fell in love with the song. But also the message of the song, I just love the message, because for Anastasia, she doesn't know who she is at all. But for like anybody else who maybe has never seen the movie, or just like is singing the song themselves, like me, can think of it for like themselves, like, I mean, everyone is lost sometimes, doesn't know the direction they're going in, and like doesn't know if they're doing the right thing, like if they're going in the right path for them. Yeah. So.
Well, I love that this means that much to you, and we cannot wait to hear it. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for Allie!
A city beyond all compare. Is it Paris? Paris. A beautiful river, a bridge by a square. And I hear a voice whisper, I'll meet you right there in Paris. In Paris. You don't what it's like not to know who you are, to have lived in the shadows, traveled this far. I've seen flashes of fire, heard the echo of screams, but I still have this faith in the truth of my dreams.
All right, let's turn it over to our judges.
Yay, Ali. Good job. You have a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful voice. Keep singing. I love your tone. You have a great vibrato. And only thing I would say is just there was a couple of pitchy places in it. But other than that, it's beautiful. Your placement and your range is great.
Thank you.
So I have nothing really bad to say about your performance. Good job, hon.
Thank you.
How do you feel? How do you feel?
Good. Yeah, good.
Did you get out? Is that the story you wanted to tell today?
Yes. Yes.
I'm so glad your friend sang that song because now it's your story. And didn't she sound beautiful?
Woo-hoo. Yes.
Thank you.
One more time for Allie, everybody. Thank you. Are you ready for your next performer? Make some noise for Lily Noel, everyone. You look gorgeous
this afternoon. You too.
Well, thank you. How old are you? What are you singing, and why did you choose that song?
Well, I'm 16 years old. Today I will be singing You Say by Lauren Daigle. And I love this song because it has such an amazing message, not only as a Christian, but also as a human being with emotions. I know we all feel those times of like we're not unworthy, or we're not worthy, we're not good enough, we're not strong enough to get through what we're going through. And this song really connects with its listeners, saying you are worthy, you are good enough, and you can get through this. And that's why I love singing this song, because it gives such a great reminder.
We all love that message, and we cannot wait. One more time for Lily, everybody. Judges.
Lily, that's such a beautiful song, and you really sang it beautifully. Most importantly, I believed you interpreting that lyric, and you have a really lovely tone to your voice. The thing that I would caution you is, because aspects of the verse are so low, always support the low end as much as you would like a big belty note.
And don't
let yourself swallow that up. But even so, I believe the conviction. I believe that you've got a tremendous amount of talent, and I believe that you did a great job with that song.
Thank you so much.
Lily, how do you feel?
I feel awesome. This is so fun.
Thank you for sharing that message with everyone. I think it's a message all of us need to hear from time to time. You're born to do this. Thank you for sharing your gifts.
Thank you so much.
One more time for Lily, everybody. Okay, are you ready for your next performer? Show some love for Danica Ruiz. I love that they get some time to strut back here, so I love it. How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling good and excited.
I love excited. So how old are you?
I'm 14.
14. These kids got some courage, everybody. So tell us, what are you singing, and why did you choose this song?
I'm singing Jealous, and I chose this song because if you listen to the lyrics and the words, it kind of shows that, you know, some people are going to go in and out of your life, and even if they're not in your life anymore, you still wish them the best no matter what happened, and you want them to be happy.
I love that message.
Thank you.
When you're ready, take it away. Give it up for Danica.
Good. I think the whole room felt how much emotion you put into that song. I would just say in a couple of the high notes, control it a little bit more. It got a little pitchy in some parts, but so captivating. Such a beautiful song for you to sing, and thank you. That was so beautiful. Thank you.
Danica, how do you feel?
I feel good.
I love that. You think when you hear the word jealous, it's a negative emotion, but I love that you picked a song that looks on the positive side of that emotion.
Thank you.
And when you story tell to people, what is performing in your life?
Sorry.
Like when you story tell and you share your emotion, what does that mean to you? What is performing in your life?
Oh, performing, I feel like it's just getting out there, kind of feeling the emotion of the song, feeling what you're saying.
Is it something you want to do for the rest of your life?
I do, yeah.
I hope you do, because it's such a gift.
Thank you.
One more time for Danica, everybody.
Thank you.
All right, everybody. Make some noise for Izzy North. Don't rush. You look beautiful.
My shoes are going to fall off.
That's okay. You just make it part of the scene. It's part of the story. So, how old are you, Izzy?
I just turned 12.
Just turned 12. Is that a good birthday?
Oh, yeah, you could say that.
Yeah. She's like, I threw you a party and everything. Come on.
Well,
she loved it. She loved it. Tell me, what are you singing today and what does this song mean to you?
I'm singing Waiting for Life to Begin from Once on This Island. And this song means a lot to me because when I was going through like a really rough patch a few months ago, this song really like brought my hopes up. And I hope it brings all of yours up, and I hope it makes you feel happy and proud of who you are. And I hope all the other contestants feel good after this.
That is super sweet. I love that you shared the message with all of us. We cannot wait. So give it up for Izzy North.
A stranger racing down the beach, racing to places I was meant to reach. My stranger, one day you'll arrive. You're
hear my prayer. Don't single me out and then forget me. Oh God, let me fly. Send me to places where no one before me has been. You spared my life, show me.
Take it away, judges.
Good job. Is musical theater, is that your genre? That's what you want to do?
Yeah, it is.
Yay. Well, I could tell. And great song choice. I love, love, love that show. You have great range. You hit that high note. You hit all the high notes. Everything sounds great. Only thing at the end, the last note, I think it was a little pitchy. But other than that, it would sound great. And keep working on musical theater. I see you right there. You know, your personality, your energy is fabulous.
Thank you.
How do you feel, Izzy?
I feel okay. Yeah, I feel good.
You should feel great.
I feel okay.
That was wonderful. Wasn't it wonderful?
Yes.
And I love that the kids are, they're everyone's biggest fan. Make some noise, kids over there. I love the support for one another. Any final words to the audience?
I just want to say I hope everyone feels happy and okay with how they are right now. And if you're ever feeling like down or anything like that, just remember this song. This song is nice and fun.
You are the sweetest. I love that, Miss Izzy. Give it up for Izzy North. Oh my goodness, the bravery of these kids. I'll take this tech moment to remind you the 50-50 raffle is open throughout the show. Matthew, give a wave. Matthew just flew in from Virginia to run the raffle. Welcome back, and it's gonna be right over there in that corner, right, Matthew? How much have we raised so far? 200, we're halfway to what we did last show. We're gonna get there, I promise. All right, are you ready for your next performer? Show some love for Lola Crawford. Let us know if that's a good level for you.
Yes. Oh, I don't want to trip over this.
Yeah, we'll fix that for you.
Yes.
We're just going to...
There we go.
There you go. So how old are you?
I'm 17.
17. And what are you singing today, and why did you pick that song?
I'm singing Killing Me Softly with his song by the Fugees because it's just such a lovely song. And there's so many versions out there, and they're all so amazing. And I feel like this song is just so true as well because there's so many songs out there with words that really get to me and can really get to other people too. So
yeah. I love that you connect with it. We can't wait. One more time for Lola, everybody.
Heard he sang a good song. I heard he had a style. And so I came to see him and listen for a while. And there he was, this young boy, stranger to my eyes. I fell all flushed with fever.
turn it over to the judges.
Lola, I have nothing but praise, and that's not because we share the same last name, but I don't think this audience realizes how brave it is to begin a vocal on a song where you really don't have any musical chord support underneath, and you came in strong and powerful and just nailed that entrance, and then proceeded to sing a song that we're all so familiar with in one version or another and make it your own. You were doing your own licks, your own interpretation. You should feel really good about that performance. Just give us more of, let us see your joy in singing that song. Be equally present on the mic with your vocals as you are in your face, because I thought the groove was really cool. I thought your voice, your tone is really cool. I just wanted to see more of that sparkle in your eye, but that's not taking anything away from the way that you just sang that song for us just now. So congratulations, and feel really good about that.
Thank you.
Lola, how do you feel right now in this moment?
I feel all right.
You should feel more than all right. He's right. Any musician who knows this song, you get that one bass note for your entire pitch reference. And she came in spot on. You were spot on about that, Doug. You did it. You should feel great. How did she do, everybody? Soak it in. You were meant to do this. You have such a gift. I hope you continue to share it. One more time for Lily, everybody.
Thank you.
Lily. Lily's coming next. Thank you, Lola. Give it up for Joe. Thank you. In fact, thank you to Esports Arena. They've been donating their venue to us for 4 years now. Can we get a big round of applause for Esports? Amazing. Do you want a mic stand? No. Come on over here. Let's give it up. Here, I can't do that with. I tried. Christoph, everybody. Hi. How are you feeling?
Good.
Good. So, Christoph, how old are you?
12.
12. So, what are you singing, and what does this song mean to you?
I'm singing Wayward Son by Kansas.
Yes.
I chose this song before because my dad listens to a lot of rock, and it meant like, I just listened to a lot of rock, and it just meant something to me. But now, my dog recently passed away, and I want to like tribute this to him. Because some of the lyrics really remind me of him and like me and my family.
Your dog just passed. Mm-hmm. Anyone have fur babies? We get it. Send them some love. Give them some positive energy. Your fur baby's gonna love that you're dedicating this song to him. So are you ready? All right. Give it up for Christoph. Take it away.
Once I rose above the noise and confusion, just to get a glimpse beyond this illusion. I was soaring ever higher, but I flew too high. Though my eyes could see, I still was a blind man. Though my mind could think, I still was a madman. I hear voices when I'm dreaming. I can hear them say, carry on my wayward son, there'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest, don't you cry no more. Masquerading as a man with a reason, my charade is the event of the season. And if I claim to be a wise man, well, it sure means that I don't know. On a stormy sea of moving emotion, tossed about, I'm like a ship on the ocean. I set a course for winds of fortune, but I hear the voices say, carry on my wayward son, peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest, don't you cry no more.
Give it up for Christoph. Take it away, judges.
Great job, Christoph. Your energy and your vibe is so contagious. The whole room felt it. We were all rocking out with you. And I know your dog was rocking out somewhere else with us as well. I want to say great job. I would just say use your space a little bit more. This is a big song. And like I said, your energy, I could see you moving up and down and looking at the audience, pointing around a little bit. But yeah, that's your stage, move it, use it. Doug would tell me that all the time. And I think it's effective. So great job, that was great.
Thank you.
My rocker, how did that feel?
Good.
How's your neck? That's good. I can't do that at my age. I'll feel it in the morning, but that was wonderful. You were meant to do this, the stage presence. So I know your dad played a lot of rock, but do you now also love old school rock?
Yeah.
All right, where's Dad?
Over there.
Nice work. So there are many opportunities. We have a live band, like we have a class on Sundays where we put kids in front of a live band and they get to do their own show. You need to have a live band behind you with those moves. How do you feel?
Good.
Good. You are awesome. One more time for Christoph. All right, show some love for Lily Atamian. How are you doing, Lily? I know, I gotta remember it's 41 contestants. Lily, how are you feeling?
Good, how are you?
I am wonderful. Tell us how old you are.
I'm 12 years old.
12, and what are you singing and why is this song special to you?
I'm singing Better Place by Rachel Platinum. This song is special to me because in a world that can be so divided, this song can really bring everyone together. You can't help just smile and feel good when you hear it.
I love that message. Thank you for sharing that with all of us. Are you ready?
Yes.
Yes. All right. Are you guys ready? All right, Lily, take it away.
I love your spirit. It just you did a great job. Your voice
you.
Is so sweet and soothing. I can listen to you all day.
Thank you.
You have great tone, great pitch, and I love the way you gave us levels in that song. You took it somewhere. You know what I mean? So keep working on this song. This is a great song for you. I love the meaning of the song. So keep picking out good songs like this, and that song was great for you. Good job.
Thank you so much.
Lily, how do you feel?
I feel really good.
You're like pure joy. Do you feel the joy emanating from her? I love that song. Tell me about that artist again. Who is that?
Her name is Rachel Platinum.
Rachel Platinum. I love that.
Yeah, she also wrote Fight Song, which I know is very
Rachel Platinum. Platinum, right? Yes. Well, thank you so much for sharing that message. It's a good story that everyone needs to hear, isn't it?
Yes.
One more time for Lily Atamian, everybody.
Thank you.
All right, give it up for your next performer, Naomi Perry. How are you feeling today?
I'm good.
Just good?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Are you all right? Well, tell me, how old are you?
I am 13.
13? What are you singing today, and why did you pick that song?
I'm singing Man in the Mirror by Michael Jackson because I've been singing this song since I was 4 years old, and I just think everybody can make a change for the better.
That is another great message. Michael Jackson since 4 years old. I love it. We cannot wait. Show some love for Naomi, everybody.
Took a classic song and a timeless message, and you delivered it with so many good elements that you should feel really proud. I noticed at one point you started, it looked like you were going to move, and I was like, okay, here she goes. And I think you maybe held yourself back, and I would just encourage you, whenever you have those instincts and you're feeling that, go. Just go with it, because your body is feeling something and telling you something, and there's no reason. The stage is yours. The audience is yours. You have us captivated. We're in your hand. And if you just kind of like turn that self-censorship aspect to your performance off and you just went for it, we would have gone crazy for you. Mm-hmm. So the instinct is right, and trust your instinct. I also thought once you hit that key change, not only did the key change, but your dynamic did too. And it seemed to fuel you. So I thought you kept getting better and better throughout the song. And please know that, like, whether I'm talking about your movement or anything else, it's all just because I'm just recognizing something that I think that you potentially are gonna do really, really well. But all of that being said, you did a great job with that song, so thank you.
Thank you.
Naomi, okay. Do you feel a little better than just all right now?
Yes, I feel
great. Yes,
what? I feel amazing.
And amazing. Yes. What do you think, audience? I love it. I love it. Everything you're doing, we want to be right there in it with you. What a gift. Thank you. I'm just unrolling this. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Ella Preslin. beautiful. How are you feeling today?
I'm feeling great.
How old are you, Ella?
I'm 18 years old.
18?
Yes.
Oh, you're already going away to college and all that good stuff on the horizon. Tell us what you're doing today and why did you pick the song?
Okay, I'm singing Stuck With You, and I chose the song because it's really special to me because it's a song that brought me throughout quarantine, and it was actually the song that I sang for my audition 2 years ago, and I always find myself coming back to this song, and I think it has a great message because even when you're stuck in a situation, you can still make good out of it and have a better outcome, so that's what
I love that, Ella. We can't wait. Make some noise for Ella Preslin.
Stick around, no. One strike and you're out, baby. Don't care if I come crazy, but you never let me down. No, no, that's why when the sun's up, I'm staying still, laying in your bed. Ooh, 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 ooh. Got all this time on my hands. Might as well cancel our plans, yeah. I could stay here for a lifetime. So lock the door and throw out the key. Can't fight this no more. It's just you and me, and there's nothing I can do. I'm stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you. Whoa, baby, come take all my time. Go on, make me lose my mind. We got all that we just you and me, and there's nothing I'd rather do. I'm stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you. And drive me insane, baby, run your mouth. I still wouldn't change all this loving you, hating you, wanting you. I'm stuck with you, stuck with you, stuck with you.
Turn it over to the judges.
Ella, I love that song. I definitely think the song is great to keep working on for you. I would just say support some of the lower notes in the beginning, just a little bit more. And I love your smile. I love the shades, by the way. And I love how you worked the stage. I loved it. It was great. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Ella, how do you feel?
I feel great.
Okay, we all love that song. Did you see how the whole crowd was just automatically dancing? Yay. And your spirit and the way you were storytelling through just totally matched the vibe of the song. I've seen you grow throughout the years, and I'm just so proud of you. And I know we might lose you to college next year, but come back maybe as a teaching artist.
Of course, yes.
I love it. Give it up for Ella
Preslin.
All right, so we're gonna take a little moment to set up our next performer, but just a little synopsis of Get Launched Vegas. We created Get Launched when we first started Get Launched 7 years ago. It was not a competition show. It was just a way for children to be paired with mentors and showcase what they learned. But we realized that as students were going around in the real world and they were going to auditions and going to interviews, and they kept hearing the word no, and we were not at Positively Arts creating a situation to really teach them how it is. Because even though at Positively Arts we're all about, yes, you're awesome, here's a moment to shine, you're so wonderful, we realized we were not truly preparing them for what happens in real life. And sometimes the word no happens. So we changed Get Launched to still be mentorship, to still have feedback from professionals in the industry, but we added the competition element supported by a community. So if these students do reach an obstacle, they could use that as a stepping stone to succeed, to get more confidence, to review, to work harder, and sometimes realize you can still be great and still be the best, and sometimes you still hear the word no. And that's life. How many people out there know that you did your best and you've still heard the word no? Make some noise. These kids need to know that no is not a bad word. No is so subjective, and no just means, all right, I'm gonna keep going, and I'm gonna go to a different audience or a different place, and I'm gonna keep being me and express myself. So we created this competition show as a way to pair them with mentors still, but put them through a process where if you hear no, that's okay. We still give you opportunities. If you joined our fundraising teams, you'll see we offer free masterclasses. There'll be more performance opportunities at our studio. So please, whatever happens next week when we have the results, we want them to stay in this program. So we keep putting them on stage, keep building their confidence, keep giving them opportunities for mentorship and reasons and ways to grow. So thank you so much. Give it up for the mentors who take their time and volunteer to work for these kids. We love you guys up there. Are we ready? Did I stall enough? Give it up for Cam Arcus, everybody. Now, Cam, you were with us two Get Launches ago. It's so good to see you back. And you were on this stage, right?
Yeah.
All right, so how are you feeling?
It's a little weird to be back after quarantine, but I'm happy.
You're happy, we're happy you're here. Why don't you tell us a little bit about this song and what it means to you?
I'm singing No Scrubs by TLC. And
oh, wow.
I chose it because the meaning behind it is, it means a lot to me. It's about female empowerment and respecting yourself as a woman and to not change yourself to make anyone else happy. So
I love that, and we all love some TLC. So make some noise. Take it away, Cam.
A scrub is a guy that thinks he's fine and is also known as a buster. Always talking about what he wants and just sits on his broke. So no, I don't want your number. No, I don't wanna give you mine. And no, I don't wanna meet you nowhere. No, don't want none of your time. Yeah. See, the scrub is checking me, but his game is kind of weak. And I know that he cannot approach me, cause I'm looking like class and he's looking like trash. Can't get with a deadbeat. So, no, I don't want no scrub. Scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me. Hanging on the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. I don't want no scrub. A scrub is a guy that can't get no love. Wanna get with me with no money.
Take it away, judges.
Hey, Cam. Good job. There is no one like Cam. I can tell you that right now. I love the way you took this song and you made it your own. It kind of, you know, it's like a hip-hop song, and you kind of gave it a little, like, folk kind of,
totally.
You know, just whatever you did with it, it was great, and I was loving it. I love it, love it, love it. So, yeah, and then your voice. You came out with that note at the end. You know, it's like, so you have a great range. You're very talented. And I can't wait to see where you go in this competition.
Thank you.
Good job, honey.
Thank you.
Cam, that was so cool. Who out there knew that song? Who likes this version better? See, you're the kind of artist that we want you to just put out an album so we can get the Cam versions. Do you write music?
Yeah, I love
Well, we have songwriting classes at our studio, and we really want to see what you do, because your voice lends well to the recording studio as well. Thank you. One more time for Cam. Joe, making everybody sound good, look good. Give it up for Desmond over there in the sound booth. Thank you for making everyone sound good, Desmond. We love you guys. All right, next up, show some love for Brianna Cirillo. Brianna, how are you feeling today?
I'm good. How's everyone in the audience feeling? Yeah.
Go take it. I love it. So tell us about the song you're singing and why did you pick it?
I'm singing The One That Got Away by Katy Perry. And the reason I chose this song is because it's a reminder for me and everyone else to always be grateful for what you have and to show the people around you how grateful you are for them, because they might not know how important they are to you.
I love that. I love that message. Thank you so much. Are you ready?
I am ready.
All right, give it up for Brianna, everybody.
Summer after high school, when we first met, we'd make out in your Mustang to Radiohead. And on my 18th birthday, we bought matching tattoos. Yeah, well, someone said you had your tattoo removed. Saw you downtown singing the blues. It's time to face the music. I'm no
job. I love that you took a Katy Perry pop song that we all know and made me think that this could exist in a contemporary Broadway musical. And I credit that to you, because not only was the song a great choice, but I believed your performance. I thought you performed it and acted it beautifully. You have a lovely, lovely voice and capable of a big belt, as you displayed, and I love your head voice as well. I think you should be extremely proud of that performance. And me, being the big Broadway musical theater fan that I am, I want to thank you for turning that Katy Perry song into a completely different experience for me. So great job.
Thank you so much. And thank you for listening to me.
Are you on your debate team at school?
I just joined it recently, actually. So.
It's perfect. You're such an eloquent speaker.
Oh, thank you.
Let me know if you want to co-host an event sometime.
I mean, yeah, let me know.
Oh, my goodness. How old are you?
I'm 15.
15. Such a seasoned performer, right? I love it.
Thank you so much.
You feel great?
Yes, I feel amazing. I'm so grateful to be able to perform on this stage. Aww. It's awesome here.
You're the sweetest, and we loved it so much. Give it up for Brianna, everybody.
Thank you. Amazing.
I love this love that happens right here. This is the gold. Like, if you're looking over there, every time they leave stage, so much love and support. That's what we do at Positively Arts. I know there's a lot of different performing arts places in town, but we really want to create a safe and supportive and loving environment. So give it up for these kiddos for supporting one another. I love the love. All right, show some love for Gabriela Almaraz. I love your dress. A little pop of red there.
Yes.
How are you feeling?
Excited.
Excited, I love that. Tell me about what you're singing and why is this song important to you?
I'm singing, I'm sorry.
You're good. You know what, wait, hold on, I need something. Do you mind if I do something? I'm feeling a little nervous, I need some big breaths. Can you guys take 3 big breaths with me? Okay, here we go, can you help me?
Yes.
Okay, here we go, 1. 2. Give me 1 more. I needed that. Sometimes I'm hosting and I get so nervous and I talk so fast. Thank you for doing that for me. So tell me, what did you pick today and why did you pick this song?
I picked Girl on Fire, and I picked this song because last year I didn't have so much confidence, but this year that song really boosted me up.
Yes, who loves this song? I can't wait, I know we can't wait. So give it up for Gabrielle, everybody.
She's just a girl and she's on fire, hotter than a fantasy, lonely like a highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire, filled with catastrophe, but she knows she can fly away.
Judges.
Wow, Gabriela, that's such a big song. And the fact that you chose it, you're confident singing it, you killed it. It was so, so good.
Thank you. I love your
energy, love the dress, love the shoes. Had to say that, sorry. Love everything about it. I loved it. It was so good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Wait, stay right there. How do you feel in this moment?
Good. Relieved.
Relieved? You just, we were not expecting that. You have such a gift in there. And you gotta know that every single person, look them in the eyes, they cannot wait to hear you. Am I right? You gotta share that forever and always. Promise?
Promise.
It's so good.
Thank you.
Give it up for Gabrielle, everybody. Wow. All right, make some noise for Alyssa Schwartz, everyone. Woo-hoo! Hi, lovely. How are you feeling today?
I feel good.
Good, you look beautiful.
Thank you.
So what are you singing and why did you choose the song?
I am singing I'm Not Afraid of Anything from Jason Robert Brown's Songs for a New World. And I chose it because I can kind of relate to the character and how she just wants to like break out, but some people are holding her back because of their fears. And sometimes I hold myself back, so it kind of relates.
Not today. I cannot wait. Give it up for Alyssa, everybody.
I hear the calling of excitement. Can you feel the pounding in my heart? The lights are ready, pulse is steady. I can start. Never stop the calling. Challenge, blessing on the water and the stones. And David loves me. He's afraid to tell me. David loves me. He's afraid to trust me. He's afraid to love me. And he'll always be. He's afraid of me. And I'm not afraid. more to win with anyone at all. I'm not afraid of anyone. Not a soul alive can get behind this wall. So let them call and watch them fall. 'Cause after all, I'm not afraid.
Yes! All right, judges.
Good job, Alyssa. What is that from again? Because I didn't hear the beginning. What is that from?
Songs for a New World.
Oh, I love that. Oh, gosh, I love that show. So I could just tell you're an actress. And is Broadway your thing?
Yeah.
Yes, I could tell. So, yeah, you have a great voice. You're an actress. You have great range. I can see you in tons of Broadway shows, so keep working on it. Keep doing it. And only thing I could say is take a big breath in the middle part, because this sound, you got a little pitchy just in the middle. Just take a bigger breath, and you'll get that part out. But other than that, I mean, I can't wait to see where you're going to go in this competition and in your life.
Thank you.
I'm going to see you on Broadway. Yes. Good job.
Alyssa, so not afraid. It was beautiful.
Thank you.
And she was spot on, that acting, that connection that helps us connect to the lyrics and the song so much. So thank you for your precision on that. Beautiful job.
Thank you.
One more time for Alyssa, everybody. All right, everybody, your next performer, show some love for Abby Coeto. Hi, Miss Abby.
Hi, Miss Felita.
How are you feeling?
Good, how about you?
I'm good, because like I love these people, I love the positive energy. So tell us about your song and why you chose it.
I'm singing The Climb because I know all of us went through a hard time, especially like in these past 3 years, and it's definitely not been easy, and I hope this song can inspire you all to keep on going and to keep on trying till you achieve whatever you want to achieve.
Oh, that is the sweetest, Abby. Thank you so much. Are you ready?
Yes.
All right, guys, make some noise for Abby Coeto.
There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's a climb. Come on, clap along. I feel the energy in this room. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's laying on the other side. It's a climb. Thank you.
Give it up for Abby. Woo! Okay, judges.
Before you even started singing, I just wrote down, this young lady has poise and she's so well spoken. There's a charm, there's such a likability factor with you. And I love that that carried over into your performance. Clearly you have a lot of fans in the house here because I could hear them screaming, and that was well deserved. You hit those big notes. I love that straight tone. I love that attack on those big notes. The only thing that I would caution you is you had, unfortunately, just because of the cut of the song, kind of an extended instrumental break there. And I love that you got everyone clapping so that you kept the momentum going. But just be sure that you don't like check out in your face, and you kind of lose that energy when you get the audience clapping. Really keep that energy engaged through the end. But I thought you did a great song with a great job with a really big song, and I just think it's no wonder you have the fans that you do. You're a really sweet human being. So thank you for all of that.
Thank you.
How do you feel, Abby?
Amazing.
I love that. You know, I never really listened to the words of that song until you just sang it. So that's saying something about your delivery. And wow, those big notes. What did you think? Woo! And how do you feel?
Great.
Great. Well, thank you for sharing that with us.
Thank you.
Give it up for Abby Coeto. Ooh, how we doing, audience? We're still doing all right? Thank you for keeping the energy up, because these kiddos are getting a little nervous, but we got to show them we love every second of it. So make some noise for Crystal Pentelis Hemmers.
Hello, everyone.
How old are you, Miss Crystal?
I am 16 years old.
16. What are you singing, and why did you choose this song?
So today, I will be singing Somewhere Over the Rainbow, because I've just been having more of a difficult time in my life lately, and singing this song just really helps me escape and just lets all my worries fade away, even if it's just for a minute. And I hope you all enjoy, so thank you.
Oh, Crystal, well, we cannot wait to hear it. Give it up for Crystal, everybody.
Beautiful. You have such a great control of your head voice. There are a lot of big notes, and you in that song, you completely killed all of them. You're a strong, beautiful lady, and you will get through these difficult times. You did very well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Crystal! I love that. What version of Somewhere Over the Rainbow is that?
It's the Catherine McPhee version from American Idol.
I love it, yes. And I love your version even better.
Yes.
How do you feel?
Thank you. I feel good.
It was just beautiful. I love when people take a song and spin it. It's just, and make it their own. I loved it. Give it up for Crystal, everybody. All right, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for Yanni. Look at this sharp outfit. What's up? How you feeling?
Good. How about yourself?
I'm feeling really good. I'm glad you're here looking so good. What are you singing, and why did you choose this song?
Well, I'm singing the song Begging by Måneskin. And I chose this song because one day in the car, I was with my friend. We were playing songs that we know, laughing, and she played this song, and it stuck with me. And now I got to barely knowing it to now memorizing it for this.
I love it. I can't wait to see what you do with this classic hit. Give it up for Yanni, everyone.
My secret, let me know, but I plan and see, just let me go. I'm on my knees, but I'm begging, cause I don't wanna lose you.
By the way,
thank you.
You got style. Yes, you. This song, I love this song for you. You sang it great. Keep it in your repertoire. Like I said, you got a lot of style, a lot of passion in your voice. And I also felt like, you know, in the beginning, you looked like you wanted to get ready to get into it. You can like before you get into the song, you can start dancing in the beginning. You know, give it a little groove in the top. But yeah, other than that, it was a great performance. Can't wait to see what you're gonna do.
Thank you.
Good job.
Wow, the originality that comes off you. How do you feel?
I feel really glad that, like I did it now.
Yes, you did. Did it, right? I love it. Keep experimenting with, like, you. And every time you come out, we're going to love it, right?
Thank you.
Give it up for Yanni, everybody.
Ooh, awesome. Yeah.
Woo. Okay, everybody. Make some noise for Kaylee Kornman. How are you feeling, Kaylee?
Good.
Good? All right, come center stage. Come on right here. Like your heels.
Thank you.
What are you singing and why did you choose this song?
I'm singing Wondering by Olivia Rodrigo and Julia Lester. And I chose this song because I'm always wondering what's going to happen in my future, like what I'm doing now. I'm always wondering, like, what's the effect on my future.
Oh, I wish more people would consider that. That's so awesome and thoughtful. Well, we can't wait to hear it. You guys ready? Make some noise for Kaylee.
Part of me will always have to lose. Every single time I have to choose. Swore that it felt right, but was I wrong? Is this where I'm supposed to be at all? I don't have the answers, not today. It's like nothing makes the questions go away. What'd I give to see if the grass was greener on the other side of all of hurt and loss? Or would it be enough? Or would I still be wondering if I could go back and change the past? Be a little braver than I had and bet against the odds. Would I still be lost? Even if I woke up in my dreams, feels like I might have broke the best thing that I had. I said too much to ever take it back. Scared I'll never find something as good. And would I even know it if I could? On the other side of all I'm hurt and lost, would it be enough? Or would I still be wondering how, if I could go back and change the past, be a little braver than I hide and bet against the odds? Would I still be lost? Even if I woke up in my dreams, would there still be something I'm missing? If I had everything, would it mean anything? Maybe I should turn around and take the other road, or maybe I'm just looking for a change the past, be a little braver than I hide and bet against the odds. Would I still be lost? Even if I woke up in my dreams, would there still be something I'm missing? If I had everything, would it mean anything to me?
Goodness, give it up for Kaylee. So before we go to the judges, I have to say, this was not her track, judges. This was not her cut. You just saw a pro follow the music and make it up. Give it up for Kaylee Kornman. Baby, come here. Come here. What a pro. You know, sometimes in this business, there's tech issues and sometimes things happen. And it's all about the recovery. Did you guys have any idea that was the wrong track? I hope you take this and you go, winning! Because, baby, these better be happy tears. Judges, let's hear from you, because did you have any idea?
No.
No, we had no idea.
No idea.
And what's so ironic, Kaylee, is that you were saying, when you were talking about why you picked this song, that you kind of find yourselves wondering what to expect from the future. And lo and behold, like the universe just gave you a grand lesson, because expectations can be a blessing and a curse. And more often than not, life is going to turn out exactly as it's meant to. And just sometimes because they're not how we expect it to turn out, we take that as disappointment. And I just applaud how composed you were through that interruption. These things are going to happen, especially in live arts, all the time. And you were just, you kept it together. And then for you to proceed to deliver the vocal performance that you did, when that wasn't even the cut of your song, I can't applaud you enough for what you just taught all of us.
So good.
Did you hear what he said? What you just taught all of us. There are some adults in this room, when things get tough, we still need to work on holding it together. And this young lady just showed us all. One more time for Kaylee Kornman, everybody. We love you, Kaylee. Oh my goodness, what a pro. It happens to everybody, and she just knocked it out of the park. I wasn't looking at my sheet, so I don't know who's next. Miss Dana, can you? Brindley! Brindley, see, how are you? Spider-Man Michael Jackson. Okay, all the judges wanted her jacket when she wore this the last round, so I'm glad she brought it back. How old are you, Brindley?
I'm 13.
And what are you singing, and why did you pick this song?
I am singing the Spider-Man theme song by Michael Bublé, and I chose this song because, first of all, I'm like a huge Marvel fan. Like, fangirl doesn't even describe it. Also, it's just, Spider-Man is timeless. I love how my grandpa grew up with the comics, and now me and my dad are enjoying it. and we can just all like enjoy it for several generations. And also, I just love the friendly neighborhood Spider-Man, how he just goes around helping others, doing good in his community, kind of like Positively Arts.
I see what you did there.
They just love to help out the community, and now would be a good time to say that I'm so grateful to be a part of it.
That was the sweetest segue ever, and I also love Marvel and comics, so we can't wait to feel good nostalgia. Give it up for Brinley, everybody.
Spider-Man, Spider-Man, does whatever spider can. Spins a web any size, catches thieves just like flies. Look out, there goes the Spider-Man. In the chill of night, at the scene of a crime, like a streak of light, he arrives just in time.
Judges.
Wow, that's such a unique song. I've never heard that song before. You killed that. That was very nice.
Thank you.
I loved it. Did you do that makeup yourself too?
My mom did it. I
well,
can never
so
do this.
Well, it's so good.
It's cool.
I love it. It's so cool. I love your personality. We can all tell you're a very unique person, unique soul. I love that about you. And yeah, I need to listen to Michael Bublé more now. That was really good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh my goodness. So that's a Michael Bublé version of that song?
Yeah.
I loved it. Who grew up watching Spidey and His Amazing Friends? I love that. It like brought so much joy. Thank you for picking that song. How do you feel?
I feel pretty good.
You should feel awesome. That was wonderful and amazing. Amazing Spider-Man. Give it up for Brinley Keller, everybody. Woo! All right, Mr. Nick. Make some noise for Nick Katapotis, everybody. Do you have hearts?
Hi.
Are those hearts? That's so sweet. What are you singing? Well, how old are you, Nick?
I'm 11.
11, and so much stage presence already. What are you singing, and why did you pick the song?
I'm singing Rise Up because I think like the lyrics, they have really good meaning, and they're just really good lyrics, and the song means a lot because whenever I feel down, I just think of the song and it makes me feel really good.
I love that reason. Are you ready?
Yes.
Excited? All
yes.
Right, here we go. Give it up for Nick, everybody.
You're broken down inside of living life on a merry-go-round. You can't find the out and move mountains, and I'll rise up, rise like the day. I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid, I'll rise.
Amazing. Take it away, judges.
I like to, I'm going to call Nick Mr. Personality.
Right?
Yeah. Yes, Nick. Voice. Honey, you got a voice. You got a voice. Yes. You got range. This is one of my favorite songs, so I'm glad you sang that. And for, you know, everything that's going on now, this song, we all need to rise up. So I think it's a great song choice for you. And I just can't wait to see what else you're going to do. You have a great voice, and you're going to go pretty far.
Thank you.
Good job, honey.
Woo, Mr. Nick! And I know this, so I'm going to share with the audience, because you didn't tell one bit. You had, like, zero voice 2 days ago, right? What a pro. What a pro. How do you feel?
Wow.
Good.
You should.
I feel really good.
Yay, I love it. And this is why we do it. I love this feeling. Take that feeling, bottle it up, spread it around in the world. Promise? Good.
Yes.
Okay, give it up for Nick, everybody. Woo! Aussie. Leave room for hugs. Give it up for Chloe Judd, everybody. Make some noise. Hi, Clo-Clo.
Hey.
Vision in blue. How old are you now?
I'm 13.
13. Yeah. So what are you singing, and why did you pick this song?
I'm singing Requiem from the musical Dear Evan Hansen, and I chose this song because in life, everyone goes through ups and downs and experiences pain and grief, and everyone copes with that grief and pain differently. And I hope I can share that story to everyone here today.
I love that. Everybody, please make some noise for Chloe.
Why should I have a heavy heart? Why should I stay or keep you with me? Why should I go and fall apart for you?
Okay, judges.
Chloe, wow, 13 years old, that's unbelievable to me. Your talent is overwhelming. I thought you sang that beautifully. I thought you acted that beautifully. You're going to be doing that role, I'm sure, in no time, in whatever production. They're just going to feel lucky to have you. That was a masterful performance. I really have nothing more to say other than thank you for that gift.
Thank you.
Chloe, we could all see on your face how connected you were to that song. How does it make you feel to express that?
I just really love performing for an audience. It just makes me feel amazing to share my story with them and to make them happy.
Do we feel happy out there? Woo! Just beautiful, Chloe. Thank you so much. Chloe Judd, everybody. All right, this is the last call for the 50-50 raffle, and I will say, if you purchased your 50-50 tickets online, go to the desk and get a physical raffle ticket, because we're going to be pulling a physical ticket. Matthew, where are you? Where'd you go? There, he's right there. So go see Matthew if you bought one online and get a physical ticket for it. All right, are you ready for your last but not least performer? Show some love for AJ! Don't rush. You strut. How you doing today?
Doing pretty good.
Yeah, come center stage. I won't share it with you. There we go. So how old are you, AJ?
I'm 15.
15. What are you singing and why did you pick this song?
I'm going to be singing And I Am Telling You by Jennifer Hudson. I have a personal connection to the song because I was bullied in elementary school and I was always told that I wasn't good enough or I didn't look the part. And I internalized it, and I've always like thought something might be wrong with me, but I've really learned to love myself, and with this song, I just want to let them know, once you get to know me, you're going to love me.
Can I get some applause for that? Good for you for knowing that, and we will always remind you if you ever forget. We cannot wait. Show some love for AJ, everybody. AJ, accept the group hugs. Oh my goodness, give it to the judges.
Wow.
Oh, you never disappoint. You don't have to tell us love you because we all love you. Like, oh my gosh, that song is so good. It fits your voice so well. And I just want to say, it's always the most talented people who get bullied. And you're just something else. You're a star. It's God-given. Keep going, please. You're amazing. Very good job. Thank you.
Thank you. Woo.
Oh my goodness. AJ, so how do you feel?
I feel pretty good. Yeah, I feel pretty good.
You feel pretty good. We feel amazing. And I'm just going to use you as the example because you're right here. But this is why artistic expression and support for the arts is so important for our children. Thank you to everyone who has donated. If we don't give them a platform, if we don't give them a place to shine and express themselves, they take it and they bottle it up. Please help us continue to give all these children a platform and a place to shine and gain the confidence and know their self-worth, and we can enjoy the journey and watch them really find themselves. AJ and so many other kids are going through some stuff in their life, and what they did here on stage was so brave. So I want to invite all my kiddos, come up here, all my kiddos. Get Launch Vegas is a competition, but I just want to let you know, everybody, you all won tonight. You won because you had the courage to share your stories and your gifts on this big, amazing stage. So as they're walking up, can I have a big round of applause for all of these students? Oh my goodness, I'll take that from you.